Hello, welcome back. Today we're going to build a self-improving system. So we're going to build on top of this page that we built in the last video, which is a simple one-page email sign-up form. And we're going to build a system that suggests improvements, pushes that improvement as an issue to the GitHub repository. When the issue is created, we can assign it to GitHub Copilot Agent to work on. And then we can test the improvement live on the website. If we like it, we merge it. If we don't, we scrap it. And the goal is to create this self-improvement loop. So in theory, we could run this at any time and test improvements on the website, stuff like that. We're going to be using the new Google Gemini CLI to do this. And I'm going to show you the process, show you the system and what it suggests, and hopefully you can follow along and maybe find out some interesting information about the tools and the processes that I use. If you're new here, the goal of this channel is just try bleeding edge software and tools in AI and other areas. So my goal is to just try different software so that you don't have to see what works, see what doesn't work, and yeah, please follow along. So let's get started. We're going to use Google's new Gemini command line interface, CLI, today, just to try it out. I've only tried it briefly on Windows, so I'd like to try it on Mac OS as well. And let's just install that. So let's scroll to the quick start. Seems like we can install it with this command. Let's open up a terminal window, paste that command in, see if this works. Okay, to proceed, yes. So Google Gemini CLI is very similar to Claude Code or the OpenAI ChatGPT CLI as well, which I've not used very much. But first, it will ask you to select a theme. We'll just go with the default. We're going to log in with Google because I have a Gemini Pro account. Once you've authenticated, we have access to a command line very similar to what you'd see in Claude Code. But I guess the context will be bigger because I believe the Gemini context is still bigger than Claude. So what I want to do is I'm going to tell Gemini what our goal is here. We're going to keep things simple for this video. In the future, it would be great to add the ability to analyze analytics data or user data. But for now, we're just going to get the system working. And to do that, it's going to be a simple prompt, something like just suggest an improvement for signups to increase the number of signups on this page. Hopefully, the LLM will then be able to think of a small improvement on the page that can make some kind of optimization, anything really, and then create an issue on GitHub based on that improvement. So yeah, we'll come back to this and improve it in the future, in future videos. But for now, let's just get this part of the loop working, so that we can ask the LLM, we can run the script and it will automatically suggest an improvement. So let me create that, let me dictate that initial prompt. I want to create a system which will analyze the code base in this directory and suggest a small improvement to optimize email list signups. This improvement can be visual or it can be a code improvement to improve the performance, but the goal is to try and maximize the number of people that are signing up to the mailing list. Once you have a suggestion, once the system has a suggestion, I want to automatically create an issue on the GitHub repository and summarize the suggested improvement in that issue. Okay, so let me paste that prompt in, and let's get this started. Okay, so let's check what Gemini is planning here. Analyze the code base. I'll examine the existing code for email signup form, including the front-end component. Okay, great. Suggest an improvement. Based on my analysis, I'll provide a specific actionable improvement to optimize email signups. Create a GitHub issue, and then create a GitHub issue. Okay, great. I think it's just going to do this in the LLM, which is not exactly what I want. I should have specified that this needs to be a script or some kind of service that I can run locally. So let's just, it seems it's got stuck on some kind of print working directory commands. So I'm going to interrupt it here with an escape and say, actually, I'd like you to build this as a script or service so that I can run this process whenever I want. We can use a Gemini API key to run the prompts, and I'll provide access details to GitHub so that we can create the issue. Each time the script slash service is run, it should suggest a new optimization or improvements. Okay, so hopefully that will get us back on track. Let's see what it comes up with. Okay, of course, I will build a script that you can run to create a new improvement suggestion and create a GitHub issue for it. Here's the plan. I'll create a file named suggestimprovement.js inside the scripts directory. Okay, read the code base. Yep, that's great. Call the Gemini API and create a GitHub issue. Okay, perfect. To use the script, you'll need to provide a Gemini API key and a GitHub personal access token. I'll add an ENV file to store these. Git ignore. Okay, perfect. I'll start by creating the scripts directory and. Okay, so like Claude Code, it always asks you the first time you run a command. So I just allow, unless it's a very sensitive command, like a running a script or fetching code from the internet, then I'll just allow it and let it do its own thing. But yeah, I think for this kind of thing, you do need to be careful because if you let it do too much and it goes rogue, then you might have a problem on your hands. So it looks like we've created the first version of the suggest improvement script. Okay, great. Let's do that. Always allow. And then it's created the .env file and the .git ignore. Perfect. We'll have to go through and edit those manually. I'm trying to not use cursor in this example. I want to use the Gemini CLI as much as possible, but there may be like a couple of instances where we do need to drop in and edit something. We'll see. Okay, so now we're going to install the dependencies. Yep, that sounds good. Okay, so the dependencies are installed. It's now asking for the credentials. I'm just going to do this and edit the .env file and add these credentials quickly. Okay, I've added those things. Let's ask it to continue. Let's test this script. Okay, I've added the credentials. Let's test the scripts. And I'm hoping that this will do everything. I'm going to actually have a look at this script afterward to see exactly what it's doing and what the prompt is. So it's trying to run the script here. Let's see if it works first time. Okay, so it looked like that worked this time. So there was a couple of syntax errors. It was using the wrong model. It was trying to use Gemini Pro, but we've changed it to 1.5 Flash, which is fine for this first test. And it says that it's created this GitHub issue. Remove optional first name field. So let's just test this out. So in theory, this is the GitHub repo. We should have a new issue. Excellent. Okay, so it's created this. Let's have a look. Currently, the signup form requests both email and first name. While collecting first name might seem beneficial for personalization, it adds an extra step and can decrease signup conversion rates. Okay, I mean, this makes sense. So let's try it out. So the next step would be, let's just check this current state of the website. So this is the basic one page app. We've got the first name, which is optional, which is like fine, to be honest. I think most people would be okay with that. But the system seems to think that removing it will increase signups. Whether it does or not, we're not going to know, essentially. But for the purposes of proving that this loop works, we'll go forwards. But in the future, hopefully, we'll have more data and we'll be able to actually make informed decisions. And the beauty of this is you can test it and roll it back. Like, you don't have to stick with a change. But we covered GitHub Copilot Agent in a previous video, but just to briefly recap, it's an agent you can run on github.com, and the way it works is you can assign it to issues, much in the way that you'd assign it to a developer. You can assign it to Copilot. You need to set things up in your GitHub settings first. This won't be available to everyone, and you also need to have a certain level of access. You need to have a certain subscription, which I have. So check that first if you can't see it. But once you do have it, you'll be able to assign it to Copilot, and then Copilot will pick it up and start working on it. So in theory, once Copilot has picked this up and created the change, we should be able to live preview what the website will look like without this first name, without this first name field. And then if we like it, we like the improvement, we can merge it back, merge into main. What should happen, I think, is that Copilot will create a pull request that we can then review and test it out on the on the branch and merge it if it's successful. So we've got the pull request that's been created automatically by Copilot. And thanks for assigning this issue to me. I'm starting to work on it and we'll keep this PR description up to date as I form a plan and make progress. And I think that we can follow along with the documentation. So you can see that it's created its own branch, I believe. You can view the session, which is familiar to anyone that's used to using LLMs or to using LLM clients for coding. Essentially, it's the same as doing it in Cursor or Windsurf, but it's doing it on a remote server. So this can carry on in the background whilst you go and get a cup of coffee and then come back and review the pull request when it's done. All right, so we are completed, and it took just over 15 minutes, which, if you're used to vibe coding in any other synchronous tools, then that's quite slow. But still, 15 minutes is pretty good going, considering. And one thing I do like about Copilot Agent is it's very thorough. So it will go through, double check things, it will document things. You can see it's updated the README file, it's updated the relevant documentation in the docs folder, it's checked for linting errors, it's actually fixed some errors I didn't ask it to, and it seems to have completed the task. So when it's finished, it creates this summary, and then we can go to the pull request and we can see that we have this pull request that marks as ready now. Another good thing actually is it sends you an email. So if you are out and about and you've set it a task, you can check in on the task. It'll tell you when it's finished. So in terms of notifications, it's very good as well. I'm actually a big fan of Copilot Agent. I still don't use it that much, having said that, because I prefer just to get my hands dirty in Cursor. But I think if I was working on bug fixes or working more on a larger code base, I would use this more. Okay, so this pull request looks good. I think we should be able to preview the deployment. So actually, it wasn't connected to Versal, I think, this project yet. So I just went into my project settings and connected it to the correct GitHub repository. So you need to do that before running this if you want to preview it. But for now, we're just going to merge this and preview on the main branch. Very low risk, this one. So let's merge the pull request, confirm merge, and this will merge it onto main. And this should automatically deploy on Versal this time. Yeah, looks like our production deployment worked. So let's go back to the live website, do a refresh, and there we go. And it's a very simple change, but it worked. So I'm going to test this a little bit more, but I think that this will be a lot more powerful if you give it access to more data. I'm imagining a system where it has a automatic feedback loop where we're able to analyze user data, maybe user behavior on the website, see what people are doing, and then optimize the website for that activity. So for example, if this was a more complex process and there were many stages, we could see if users were dropping off on a certain page or if they were having problems with some kind of user experience or UI, and then feed that data to the LLM, get the LLM to suggest a way of improving that, and then we could even split test that deployment with the live deployment and see if it fixed our problem. The issue with doing that is you need to have a lot of users, and we don't have that. But I'm kind of hoping to build a system that would work in the future and just experiment a little bit with this whole self-improvement cycle and try and just get something running, even on a really simple, low traffic scale, just to see what would happen, how good it would get. Maybe we would run this script once a week or even once a day in the future, and we could have multiple experiments running where we're checking for, we're testing a hypothesis, basically. The system or the script comes up with a hypothesis, says, I think that this change would improve user signups. We then split test it on a large enough user group, and if that hypothesis is proven true, then we merge it into main and it becomes part of the main website. If it's false, then we scrap it and we try something else. That's kind of the goal. So we'll see if we can get there. Hopefully we can get part of the way there, but please follow along if you would like to see that journey, and I'll see you in the next one.